How can you tell as soon as possible whether you're dealing with a narcissist? And we're talking about here specifically in the context of a family or a romantic relationship. Although you can extend it also to friendship, and you can also extend it into a work environment. But I'm going to draw a distinction here. But there's one thing that you can do in order to perform a test. And it's a test you do more or less in your own head, and it just may connect you to your internal sense of self, to your internal feeling that is going to be very revealing, because the information you're going to get as a result of your inquiry should be quite rich and dense. Narcissists are highly conditional beings, and this is the key to this inquiry. So how can you tell whether you're dealing with a narcissist? How can you within seconds, as soon as possible, tell? Because there's a list you can follow. There are tests you can do as, for instance, setting a boundary and saying no to them, in which case they're usually going to react negatively to that because they don't like boundaries. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about in this video is something a little bit different. And basically what it is and what it comes down to is they're going to tell you things or imply things that sound like this: I love you if, or I'm going to give you this if, or I'm going to like you or be your friend if. Everything is conditional. So while they may not say that to you directly, because to have a narcissist actually admit how they think is a typically rare occurrence. Sometimes it just slips out. Sometimes they just almost accidentally tell you the truth. But even when they do this, it's like they have a moment when they need to sort of reassemble, and then they go back into their old way of being and thinking, and they shame you and they criticize you and they do all those things. Now, this thing that I'm talking about, I love you if, or I like you if, or I'm going to be your friend if, or I'm going to give you a raise if, is something that's very specific to the types of personalities that operate in a way to take something from you. And only then, when you fulfill those conditions, they may or may not, usually they don't, give you what you want. So this is how they test their targets. This is how they grow in their power. You may have noticed that when you actually want something from certain people, you feel like they hold power over you. That's what I'm talking about. And it's absolutely natural in our just daily life that in our interactions with people, there are power differentials, there are power differences, but they're not used to abuse other people. This is where it's taking to an extreme. And you can tell, your body can tell, you can tune into your body and figure this out and arrive at a certain conclusion that should be quite telling for you. So if you've been thinking for quite some time about whether this person or that person is a narcissist or has been abusing you, what you can do is you can do a check with yourself, and you can ask yourself, is this person holding their love or affection? Now, this often happens in families, very abusive and narcissistic families, also in romantic relationships. You can ask yourself, well, does this person love me and accept me for who I am? Does this person respect the fact that I have a different opinion from them? Or does it always come down to conflict after conflict, where I get the deep sense inside that unless I behave in the way that I'm expected, that fulfills their expectation, which can be a tricky thing because often it's a moving target, I am not going to feel accepted or loved or like I belong. And this is the theme that runs through all of the toxic relationships that I hear about and I have also myself experienced. And my heart goes out to you if you have identified with this pattern, especially in your family, because it is going to give you the sense that there's something wrong with you, deeply wrong with you, that there's this toxic shame, layers and layers of it, where you feel like unless you do something, and oftentimes you don't even know what it is, that you're not going to get that emotional nurturing and sustenance. It's very damaging. This is going to require some deep work. It's going to require some deep diving and a lot of healing. But it will result in you becoming much stronger and being able to stand on your two feet as an independent, sovereign individual. So this work is incredibly valuable, and I want to encourage you to do this, to not give up. There are moments when it gets really, really tough, and some people might turn hopeless, and my intention is to, hopefully maybe in this video and in all the videos that I should, to give you the sense that, you know, even when it gets really hard, that's usually when we hit a point where we are either exhausted or we hit a wall and we're not quite sure how to cross it. This is where someone who's been there can help you, or this is where a book can be helpful, or talking to someone you trust can be helpful. But don't give up. Keep moving forward. And before I end this video, I just wanted to mention a couple more situations in which you can also perform this test. It's going to be a little bit different, a little bit altered, not so straightforward as in I love you if, but it's more about I'm going to reward you. This is a situation at work, if you do a certain thing for me. Now, of course, there's a hard line we need to draw between, well, you need to perform well if you want to get a raise. But once we get into the territory, you have to go out with me if you want to get a raise. You have to spread your legs, or you have to, you know, do some form of a favor that falls outside of the boundary of the professional relationship. Now we're entering the abusive territory. So be very mindful of that. Same thing with friendships. If you feel that you are the one who's over investing in a relationship and you're only getting energy, approval, you only feel like the person, your friend, is listening to you or providing some form of a support when you fulfill the expectations that he or she has, then this may be an unbalanced relationship, and this may be a good opportunity for you to step back and reassess what is really going on. So I hope that this was helpful to you, this video. I love all of your support. If you are a fan of Soul GPS, thank you. Please subscribe, share, like. It all helps to spread this information. I appreciate all the letters, all the comments, and all your love. It really gives me so much motivation to continue doing this work. And if you would like to join us in New York City and also in San Francisco, we're now in 2019. On June 1st and June 15th, I'm going to be holding live workshops to specifically teach you how to set those boundaries, how to figure out where you are when it comes to boundaries, and then decide where you want to be. And I'll give you the tools to move that line and to also be flexible and agile with it, depending on the situation. We'll be doing lots of practices and exercises, and also learning how to be assertive and ask for what you want. So lots of material. It's going to be exciting. We'll be together all day. So if you're interested, information is down below as to how to get a hold of me and get your seat. We have about a handful of them left, so hopefully we'll hear from you soon. Thank you so much. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.